Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. I hope you guys are doing extremely well. Today in this video, we are going to talk about the myth, the most common myth that goes around the Tier 3 students. That is, if we do not have good Code Forces rating or Code Chef rating, people are not going to refer us. Whenever we text them, they're not going to reply us back, or they're not going to refer us to all these top product based companies. Is that true? So we're going to deep dive into that how do people decide at LinkedIn whom to refer or not? Like, whenever you drop a message to someone, on what parameters does someone decide whether he will refer you or not? So in this video, I'm going to talk about what tricks did I follow when I was a student, and what are the stuffs that we as software development engineers at all these top product based companies look for when we are looking to refer someone. Okay, so in this video, everything about LinkedIn and how to get a referral, even if you are a competitive programmer, even if you are someone who has just solved GFG or LeetCode, even if you are a dev guy, how do you get a referral from someone? That is what we are going to speak about. So yeah, without having any delay, let's get started with this video. So I'll be breaking this video into four different parts. And the first part will be whom to text for a referral. Now, again, two parts over here. One is you're a competitive programmer. The other one is if you're a dev guy and you have done a lot of DSA on LeetCode or GFG. Talking about if you're a competitive programmer, then try to text people who are into competitive programming. Let's say I am working at a XYZ company. I am a competitive programmer. So you should try to text me instead of texting someone who has done LeetCode or someone who has done dev. Because I'm someone who's going to value more competitive programming, because that's the stuff that I have done in my college days. So the chances of you getting referred will be much higher if you text me. So a competitive programmer should try, I'm not saying it's a mandatory stuff, but you should try texting people who have made it to that company via the stuff that you are good at and via that stuff which he was good at when he was in college. So there is an attraction, because it is the law of nature that if someone has done CP, is gonna like CP guys. If someone has done dev or GSOC, is gonna love the guys who have done dev and GSOC. That is how the affinity works, right? Now, if you're someone who has done a lot of dev, something like machine learning, and he has done LeetCode and GFG a lot, then you should not text a CP people, because probably he will not understand. I'm not saying this for everyone, but there are people who are like 1 year experience, 2 years experience. They might not understand your contribution, right? Because someone like me, I don't know a lot about GSOC. So I might not understand what you have done. But if you text someone who has already done a lot in GSOC, dev, a lot of LeetCode, then that guy might refer you. The chances of you getting referred will be a lot more. So I hope you've understood. If you're a CP guy, try to target CP people. If you're a dev, GSOC, LeetCode guy, try to target people who have made it via these things, so that the chances of getting a referral increases exponentially. Now, that was the first trick that I did tell you. Now, the second trick, why is this common myth that if you have ratings, you're gonna get referred? I'm gonna tell you about this. Now what happens is, let's assume Amazon is hiring. So what you do is, you basically type Amazon in your search box, and then you send requests to people who are working in Amazon. And generally, the profiles that appear at the top are the people with maximum number of followers or maximum number of engagement ratio. And generally, the people with maximum number of followers generally are people who are into competitive programmers or who are very much active. So what happens is, either they're getting a lot of text because they have a lot of followers, or they're into competitive programming. So if you have done LeetCode and you're approaching those people, you might end up getting like no replies. And that is where this common myth comes up, ki just because I did not have rating, that guy did not respond me back. Whereas the core is, you're texting people who might have 100 text in his inbox, right? Or who might be a plain competitive programmer. That is why he appeared at the top of the search. So it's very important, the second trick is very important, to figure out people who are like, who are having a less number of followers. So that's the second trick. Try to figure out people who have very less number of followers and who have not done so much of CP to get a referral. Then your chances of getting a reply back will be significantly higher. Remember this, try to text people who have less number of followers, who appear on the second, third, fourth page whenever you search for a company name. Okay, so that's the second trick, but is that complete? No. Now you might end up texting people who do not actually check out LinkedIn. So whenever you're texting a people, you should be very careful that just make sure you go to their activity and see that if they have liked some post, if they have commented in the last 1 month or not, so that to get a fair bit of idea if that guy is active or not, okay? And always drop a text for referral, and make sure after 2 or 3 days, drop a follow-up text. That should be very mandatory. That's the second thing you should do, and that will clear all your myths that only competitive programmers do not get referrals. Even if you are good at lead code and you approach the correct people, then you're gonna get referrals. So that was about the second point. So before moving ahead in the video, let me thank Relevel for sponsoring this video. What if I say, no experience, no degree, only skills matters. If I give you a hiring platform where these things stand true, yes, Relevel backed up by An Academy is the first hiring platform in India which has on the basis of skills. So let me tell you about 5 companies which are offering backend development jobs for freshers, and there is no requirement of experience, degree. Someone like RazorPay, where the CTC offered is up to 20 lakhs. SuperDaily, the CTC is up to 20 lakhs. FleetX, the CTC is up to 15-25 lakhs. And there are roles at frontend development as well, where you have 1MG, Zoomcar, CodeNation hiring up to CTC of 30 LPA. I personally think that these are some really exciting job opportunities which usually a fresher won't be eligible for, but An Academy has created this amazing hiring platform called Relevel, which helps freshers and people in their early career to work with these companies irrespective of their qualification or experience. So all you need to do is, you have to register for the Relevel test, you have to give it, and after that your interviews will be scheduled and you will be hired. The entire process just takes a week, which is much faster as compared to other hiring platforms. Does it cost anything? No, it is absolutely free. So please make sure you check out all the links in the description and apply for the Relevel test as soon as possible. Coming to the third point, which is again very, very important. Now, I have seen people copying text. So it's about the message that you send. Now, a lot of people believe that you should send a hi, you should greet them, then you should come to the point. Is that the case? I will say that if you speak to 10 engineers, they will say that no, we don't like wasting time. We don't like hi, hello, kaise ho, kya kar rahe ho. We don't like that. What we like is direct communication. If you want a referral, you be straight to the point that hi, I'm so and so, I've done so and so, vagera vagera, this is my resume, I'm looking for this job ID, can you please refer me? It should be a crisp message. Now when I say crisp message, it should not be like hi, not a one liner, not a two liner. It should not be very lengthy that I skip that. It should be a very medium text where you can actually attach your resume and you can give the top 2-3 points about you which attracts me to actually opening your resume. The main thing is you should write those 2-3 lines in such a depth that I should open your resume. And once I open your resume, if you are good enough, I'm going to refer you. So the third point that I want to make sure is, the third trick that you should definitely follow is writing a text which is to the point and not very lengthy and not very, very small, and dropping a follow-up text after 2 or 3 days just to check, like just in case if he has missed your text. That's the third trick you should follow. The fourth trick, which everyone messes it up, that's very, very important. Now whenever you come to, like, for an example, now it's 2022 batch which is getting hired, right? So what they do is they go to some Microsoft's website, Amazon's website, and they just see that software development engineer one. And they do not read about the qualifications. Like in qualifications also, there's not specifically mentioned that for 2022 batch. And then they think that, okay, they're hiring SD1s, so why can't I apply? They just pick up that role and they barge into people's inbox. Now, when we open that, we see that, okay, it's not for 2020 people. So we end up avoiding that text. And that is when you again get a feeling that people are avoiding you. But actually the thing is, you are wanting a referral for a job ID which does not accept fresh graduates. So if you're a fresh graduate, try to look for job IDs which are for you. Generally, if it is for fresh graduates, they will be mentioning the pass out year also, and probably they'll be mentioned, like for Google, they mention for fresh graduates 2021 or 2022. They make sure that they mention that in their job, like the heading. Similar to Amazon also, they make sure that if they're hiring for 6 months intern, they write 2021 pass out only CSIT field. So make sure you read the job description, the requirements, and if you're fitting the requirements, then only text to people. Because let's assume you texted me, okay? Let's assume you texted me, I get hundreds of texts, but I'm reading your text, but I see that, okay, this guy's wanting a referral for a job ID which he doesn't fit in. So I will be like, this guy's not doing his research, and probably your message will go down, and the next time you will text, probably I might not read. So that's a wrong impression that you're sending of yourself. So be very careful that you do a proper research before asking for a referral to anyone. Yes, to anyone. And that will be the fourth point. Do a proper research and ask for a valid job ID only. Now, adding to this fourth point, if you are an experienced guy, make sure if you are applying for a job ID, generally if you are appearing for Amazon SD1 or Microsoft SD1 or any other company, generally for SD1 there might be 5-6 openings. Try to send all those 5 job IDs together, okay, so that you don't barge in to that inbox again and again. Try to ask him for a referral to all the job IDs, because if I'm referring you, it's very easy to refer at a time 5 job IDs instead of every other day you are asking me for a referral. So just make sure you do that very honestly. So those were the 4 points. If I summarize them, the first point is the genre in which you do basically computer programming, lead code, dev. You should target those people only. The second thing, target people with less number of followers because they will have less messages in your inbox, and target people who are like active. Right? You should not target people who haven't even liked or commented on a post from 1 year. Don't do that, because the chances will be very slim of getting a reply. Third point, the message should be crisp. Yes, the message should be super crisp, not a one-liner, not a very lengthy, very crisp. Fourth point, try to make sure you do an active research, and if you're asking for a referral, make sure that's for you only, and try to include 4 or 5 job IDs if you're asking for a referral, so that you can easily, you do not barge into someone's DM every other day. So these are the 4 points. If you follow, you're gonna end up getting a referral, and all the myths about if you have a good rating and all, like these are nonsense. Trust me, these are absolute nonsense. So guys, that will be it for this video. I hope you have understood how to ask for referrals, what are the tricks that you should definitely follow, and yes, make sure you check out Relevable. The link will be in the description. With this, I'll be wrapping up this video. Bye bye, take care.